Okay, so the James Madison University Computer Science Department actually runs a server for students to use. It's called STU, colloquially. It's available to all JMUCS students. Its fully qualified name is stu.cs.jmu.edu. It is pre-configured for CS261, so everything is set up that you will need. We are going to be using this server for all of the project distributions and the project submission. You should already have an account on this machine. The username is your EID, and the password is the same as your EID password. For technical support, if you have trouble logging in or using the machine, you should email our system administrators and also CC me if you send an email to them. So accessing the student server is going to look a little bit different depending on the operating system of your computer. So under Windows, I recommend using PowerShell or downloading a separate terminal program. I recommend either PuTTY or MOBA Xterm. On Mac, you can use the built-in terminal, or I prefer to use a program called iTerm2. And then if you have some sort of Linux on your personal computer, you most assuredly have some sort of terminal built in. So if you have a Debian-based Linux distribution like Ubuntu or Mint, then you'll want to use GNOME terminal. So in any case, once you have a command line on your local machine, you can get to STU using an SSH client. Generally speaking, you're just going to run this command here, so SSH, and then your EID at stu.cs.jmu.edu, and make sure you replace my EID there with your EID. There are a lot of other things that you can do to make it easier to connect to STU. So in particular, I recommend setting up your SSH config and your and some SSH keys so that you don't have to type in your password every time you log in. And there's more information about how to access STU and set up these things on the wiki page, which you can see the link there. So working on 261 projects, you kind of have a couple of different options. I'm going to say that my primary recommendation is that you just use STU. You edit, test, and submit on STU. So all you have to do is just SSH to STU, edit with a command line text editor like Nano or Vim, and then you can build, test, and submit right on the machine. Your files never leave the server. You don't have to worry about accidentally losing them on your local machine or anything like that. So that's my primary recommendation. I do know that some people just hate using a command line text editor. And if that's the case, then sort of the second choice for working on projects in this course is to edit the files locally, but still keep everything on STU and test and submit there. And so if you would like to attempt to do this, then you'll need to do what's called mounting your STU home folder to your local machine so that you can edit your files locally. So there are instructions about how to do that on the wiki at the address on the screen. And the benefit of this is that it allows you to use whatever text editor you'd like that you have installed locally. So something like Visual Studio Code, for instance. And then the files themselves are still on STU, so you would still need to SSH to STU to build, test, and submit. But again, the files still stay on STU, and you don't have to worry about copying them back and forth. There is sort of this third choice, which is to develop and test locally and then to submit on STU. This is not the most highly recommended option here because it involves copying files around, and there's a chance for them to get out of sync or for you to lose things if something happens on your local machine. But if you do want to pursue this option, if, for instance, you really have to be able to work offline and not connected to STU, then what I recommend is that you set up a Linux virtual machine on your local machine so that you can have a Linux environment at least. And so what you'll do is you'll copy the project files to your local machine, you'll edit it there using the text editor of your choice, and then you can build and test inside that virtual machine, although you may need to install some additional software in order to do that. And then when you're done, when you want to submit, you can copy the files back to STU, then SSH to STU and submit. And if you're going to do this, I highly recommend rerunning the test suite on STU just to make sure that there aren't any differences in the behavior between your local machine and running on Stu.